Hey guys, what's up? I just wanted to share a quick video about the Nissan Frontier and Xterra transfer case that we have here in the shop. I wanted to show you how your shifts between two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, and four-low work. So right now the transfer case is in four-low. You'll see that when the input shaft, where the transmission power comes from, you'll see that it's turning this chain right now. And this chain delivers power from your main drive shaft to your drive shaft, which powers the front differential. The part of the transfer case that determines whether or not you're in your low range or not is where this gear here is located in relation to being either this direction or this direction. The further in towards the rear is going to be four low, and forward is going to be your high range, your 1-to-1 ratio. So we are in four low right now. Chain's turning, this gear is receded back. So I'm going to show you a change into how you get into four-wheel drive high. So we're going to turn this, and you're going to see the gear be moved forward. Now we are in four high. This gear has been disengaged from the planetary gear reduction that's on the face of the transfer case, which I'll show you in a second. But you turn it and your chain is still engaged, so you know that we're still in four-wheel drive. Next, we want to go into two high. So we're going to come here, and it's going to disengage the chain that connects power to your front differential. So now we turn the input shaft, no movement on the chain. So congratulations, we are now in two-wheel drive. Now I'm going to show you super quickly how the gear ranges work on the other transfer case. So sorry for the mess. Let me flip this guy over. All right, guys, thanks for your patience. I finally got it back together. So here you go. Remember this gear that I was talking about earlier? When it is forward, you are in your high range, and when it's back, you are in your low range. So here is your planetary gear set that's on the face of the transfer case. So when this is in, all the way forward, you have a 1-to-1 gear ratio. You can see that it is turning at the same rate at which I'm spinning the gear. Your low range is achieved by these teeth engaging with these black ones right here. As you can see, we turn there, and you have your low range. So in practical sense, when you're back in your transfer case, when this moves forward, you disengage your planetary gear reduction. When it moves back, you engage your planetary gear reduction. So that is a very basics on how a transfer case works, more specifically the Nissan Frontier and Xterra transfer case, the TX-15, I believe. Hope you enjoyed, and let me know what you guys think. Thanks.